The NFL on CBS. Today's game is sponsored by Ford Truck, who invite you to see all the tough Ford pickups at your Ford dealer now during Ford Truck Week. Hertz, where the winners rent. And by the Miller Brewing Company, brewers of Miller High Life. If you've got the time, we've got the beer.
From Shea Stadium in Flushing, New York, it's the NFL on CBS. Today, the Detroit Lions versus the New York Jets. Hi, everybody. Kurt Gowdy with Hank Stram. Hey, think of the worst thing that could have happened to you last week. Nothing could compare what would happen to the Lions and the Jets. The Lions, on an embarrassing 12th man on the field penalty, gave the Redskins a chance to win. 8 seconds to go. And the Jets suffered the worst defeat in their history against the New England Patriots. Now, Henry, here they are back again. How does a team wipe out what happened a week ago? They're both off to slow starts also.
One thing that you have to do in professional football as a football coach is make sure that your squad learns one word, the meaning of one word, and that's forget. You must be able to forget, especially a loss. You can't be too overjoyed with a victory because you have to avoid the peaks and valley, the roller coaster ride that exists week to week. So they have to forget, and they got to be worried about winning this game here this afternoon.
They're both very young teams. Does this help them forget?
I think it does, because young teams really don't know any better.
Well, we're going to find out, and we're going down on the field now here at Shea Stadium, and it is a beautiful September afternoon. This stadium is famous for the wind, but not much breeze today. It'll not be a factor. The Jets have won the toss, and they're going to receive on your right. They're in the green or the dark jerseys, and the Lions today will be in white. Benny Ricardo will kick it off. Bruce Harper has already returned 14 kickoffs in just two games to show you the plight of the Jets so far. And back there with him will be Ken Schroy. Schroy's 48, Harper's 42. Harper has good speed. They'll try and kick it away from him. Ricardo's kick is coming to Schroy on the 12. He's up to the 20, to the 25, and he's down on his 28-yard line. Well, let's check now the offensive lineup for the New York Jets. In the line, Chris Ward, Rasmussen, Fields, Alexander, Marv Powell. There are the receivers, Walker, Gaffney, the tight end, and Schuler. And there's your backfield, Todd, Durking, and Long. Richard Todd on the 28. Goes over to Kevin Long. Long finds an opening and picks his way out to the 36-yard line of the Jets.
Nothing more than a straight-ahead play, Kurt. Dan Alexander, the right guard, Marvin Powell, 79 and 60 respectively, along with 65. Joe Fields did a good job of blocking at the point of attack, along with Scott Durking, number 25.
All right, they're on the 36 of the Jets, second down two. Doug Jones starting in place of Walt Williams at left corner today. They're trying to get this first down, and they have it over the 40. Rolling out to the 42 is Scott Durking at Purdue in his third year. 215-pounder. Doug English, the right tackle, made that stop. The Silver Rush has been badly damaged this year with injuries. The Lions had more players in injured reserve last year than any team in the NFL, and they're having bad luck again this year. Jets ball, they're 42, first down. Todd, fourth year, University of Alabama, 25 years of age. Stay right on the ground. The handoff is off to Scott Durking. And Durking slugs it out to the 45 of the Jets. He's hit there by the rookie, Eddie Cole, who beat out the number two draft pick, Cam Fantetti.
Here we go. You see Baker, number 60, on the right side. trailing the play from the right side. They evidently want to do business to their right more than their left, and that's the way they started this game, by running more to their right than to their left. Evidently, that's their game plan.
Baker has not had a sack this year. He led the NFL in individual sacks last year. He wants to have a big day. This play will be slowed down. Long is hit behind the line of scrimmage. Kevin Long. And over there on that play coming up is number 28, James Hunter, a free safety.
And Jimmy Allen, number 40,
Jimmy Allen,
was also in on the play and did a good job of reading, reacting, pursuing, and making the tackle. A good-looking play by the strong safety, Jimmy Allen, number 40.
All right, coming on, Walt Williams, 21, in there for pass defense. Ken Ellis, 48. They got a couple of linebackers, Cole and Weaver. It is now 3rd and 8 for the Jets. 44-yard line of the Jets. No blitz. Side throw. He can pitch it for a first down. Bruce Harper came out of the backfield to snag that one, and Ken Ellis drove him out of bounds. Harper's a good receiver.
Yes, he's got great speed. He comes out of the backfield. Watch him. Goes into the flat, into the flat area. Todd throws the ball right on the money. And the defensive back, 48, Kenny Ellis, was covering on the play but didn't make the coverage like he should have. 1st and 10 for the New York Jets.
New York on the Detroit 47. Cole and Weaver back in as linebacker. No score early in the first period. This is Durkin at the 45. Flag goes down, and Durkin is toppled at the 43-yard line of the Lions. Hit there by John Brooks, 53, Eddie Cole, 50, and Doug English, 78. It is holding against New York. This will set them back. This telecast presented by authority of the National Football League. It's intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the Jets and the National Football League is prohibited. Ball will go back down to the Jet 43. Let's get the call.
Holding, 72, 10 yards. First down.
Here's a story already. Chris Ward penalized 5 times in a preseason game for holding. He's been very perplexed why he's holding so much, and he's been called right now early in this game for holding.
Even though he's been holding some, he's still a great offensive tackle, and I'm sure that problem will be solved as he goes along during the course of the season.
Ricky Schuler in motion. Got a little trap, and Scott Durkin. Over his left guard, Durkin reaches the 47-yard line, a 4-yard pickup. It'll be 2nd and 16 for New York. John Brooks, the left linebacker, on that stop.
One thing we have to look for in this game early, Kurt, is the fact that Wesley Walker, the great outside receiver of the New York Jets, number 85, he commands a lot of double coverage. He's like lightning, and they also want to make sure they keep him on the line of scrimmage, and they don't want him to get a free release.
Walt Williams is on him right now, number 21, on the far side. There's a jam up, a jam on the handoff. It wasn't a smooth handoff. They bumped into each other, and that slowed the play up. Hank will dissect it for you.
It's a kind of a counter play. He takes a step. It isn't a counter. He made it look like a counter step, but he didn't know exactly where he was supposed to go. Here we see it again.
That's Walker.
Walker is going out for a pattern, but the ball carrier at that time ran into the quarterback. The mesh was not good, and it was a bad-looking play.
3rd down and 16. The Jets on their own 47. Deep drop by Todd. Baker's in there trying to get him. The toss is to Walker. He has it. Wesley Walker. Dynamite receiver, has been stopped so far this year with an average of only 13 yards a catch. But he got a deep one that time.
Watch Wesley Walker. They're trying to keep him from getting off the line of scrimmage. Luther Bradley was trying to. Played man-for-man coverage. Todd steps up into the pocket. Walker makes a beautiful leaping catch. And Bradley makes the tackle, but not until after he makes a big gain on a first down.
Walker last year averaged 24 yards a catch. His career average is 23 yards a catch, which is the best in the National Football League in the last 2 years. Durkin trying to cut back. Stopped at the 24-yard line by Al Baker, number 60, who angled in there, and Doug English, the right tackle, 78.
Scott Durkin, the left halfback, runs to the right, and that's the one thing about that formation. running from left to right across the ball is a long way to run, and you're almost committed to the hole that they're blocking for. And if there's no hole there, there's no place to go.
Richard Todd brings him up. Second down, 9. Jets ball, the Lion 24. No score. First period. 9:19 to go in this period. Backs are out. They reach him, and he's down. He's sacked by Al Baker. Bubba Baker just picked up his first sack of the year.
Watch Baker this time. Todd back into the pocket. Wesley Walker made an inside-outside move and was open in the end zone. But look at Baker. He's got no chance whatsoever. It looked like a screen pass that time. Nobody blocked him. And for that reason, he was able to make the sack on Richard Todd. But Wesley Walker was open in the end zone. Had he been able to throw the ball, it would have been 6 points.
Third down, 19 for the Jets. They're on the Lion 35. Clark Gaines and Bruce Harper in the backfield. High formation. Six secondary backs in there for the Lions. They're going to run. And that's Clark Gaines. Gaines to the 30-yard line. If they try a field goal, it will be about a 47-yarder. Some of the fans are booing. They wanted a pass on that last play.
Well, really, it wasn't a bad play. I was surprised that he wound up running outside. However, the middle was open. They didn't have a linebacker in the middle area. Had he been able to pop it, he would have made a nice gain. Plus the fact he would have been in better position to kick this field goal. That's what they were trying to accomplish. And actually, it really was a good call.
This will be a 46-yard field goal attempt by Pat Lay, who has booted 4 out of 6 so far. And that kick is up. It is going to be short, no good. And to bring the ball back to the 36-yard line, or to the 30-yard line, 29-yard line. And the Lions now will take over on offense for the first time with a score, 0-0.
It's Ford Truck Week, the biggest clearance offer in Ford truck history. The best-selling trucks of the 70s must make way for the new 80 Ford trucks. Previously announced factory incentives to Ford dealers make lower prices possible so you can save hundreds on tough Ford V8 pickups, tough Ford V8 vans, tough Ford Broncos and Rancheros too. Save hundreds on the best-selling trucks of the 70s until the introduction of the 80s. See your Ford dealer now during Ford Truck Week.
Usually people don't change insurance companies to save money. They change because of service. That's why State Farm agents work so hard to be good neighbors. When people have a question, I try to get the answer right away. It's the same with the claim. I make sure it starts out right, so it'll be handled right, fast and fair. We don't lose many policyholders.
For your life, your health, your home and your car, like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
All right, the Lions. Quite a story at quarterback. A rookie, Jeff Komlo, a number 9 draft pick. Asked to step in. He's an emergency man, but he rallied the Lions last week, second half against the Redskins. Showed enough, the Lions have hopes for him. That was Freddie Scott in motion. He'll throw on first down. Scrambling out, a screen pass. Up with the ball. Bo Robinson, the rookie fullback, the leading ball carrier, and he was close to a first down. Well set up by the rookie Komlo. He let him come in and took his time on it.
Yes, he did a good job of acting. To do a good job on screen passes, you must go back into the pocket, set up an anchor like you're going to throw, and then retreat a couple of steps. There he goes. By that time, Robinson, number 36, was in the right flat, bobbled the ball a little bit, worked on the tipping drill a little bit, but he was able to finally get the handle on the football, made a nice gain, and was tackled there by Stan Blinka, number 54.
Out of motion is Dexter Bussey. And off Robinson, first down. Robinson, who is a big back from West Texas State, weighs 225, is elusive, though, for his side. And he was brought down by Joe Klecko. First down, Lion. On the Lion, 44. Here's the Detroit offensive line. Baldeschweiler's at left tackle. Elias is at left guard. Terry is at center. Bollinger at right guard. And the rookie prize, Keith Dorney, at right tackle. Scott, Thompson, and Hill are the receiver. And Komlo, Bussey, and Robinson, the backfield. First down. Got some motion. Right up the middle of Robinson again, and he squirms and wriggles. Gets up to around, he's 48, runs into rookie Stan Blinka, number 54, the middle linebacker.
Let's see how long it's going to take them to start working on Johnny Lynn, the rookie right cornerback, number 29. He's starting for the first time, and I'm sure they're going to give him a lot of business. He's a rookie from UCLA. 6'1", 190, and it looks like there's got a lot of room over there, especially when they utilize the man in motion.
There are four rookies starting on defense for the New York Jets.
See if Scott goes in motion this time to his left.
There he goes, Fred Scott. That play is jammed up, and the Jets pile in on him. Slow developing play. The leading tackle on that was made by Joe Pellegrini and Greg Buddle, the left linebacker, number 51. Denver scored first on Atlanta. The Denver defense has not allowed a touchdown in two games. 7-0 in the first period. Norris Weiss on a 10-yard run. He's a good scrambler.
Fred Scott, when he lines up on the right side and goes in motion to the left, is covered by Johnny Lynn, and he's got a lot of room. They should take advantage of that as we go along in the game.
May have a blitz coming up here, or may not. No, they tried to pretend it was. Dexter Buckley got the call. He reaches the 48-yard line of the Lions. Mark Castano, a rookie left end, and Greg Buddle made that stop. And so the Lions have a 4th and 6, and their punting team is coming on. Larry Swider from the University of Pittsburgh played on that national championship team with Tony Dorsett. Swider leads the NFC 43.2 yards. And Bruce Harper, the deep man, to return his kick for the Jets. No wind right now. Almost dead calm. Low end over end. Harper takes it on to 15, up to the 20. And he fielded that ball well. He run out of bounds short of his 25. Came up on that kick, a low kick, Hank, on the run and grabbed it.
Yes, and it was up there, 2 9/10 seconds. Those kind of kicks usually get run back for a big game.
On a river of wood, and you never forget that the spinning shapes in the cold, dark water are your only bridge home. So you keep on dancing, and when you've coaxed enough logs into place to build a good-sized town, you can finally head for River's End and Millertime. Millertime, time for the best-tasting beer you can find, Miller High Life. America's quality beer since 1855.
When it's time to relax,
time to relax,
one beer stands clear.
Miller Beer, Miller tastes too good to hurry through.
If you got the time, we've got the beer.
Miller Beer.
Wednesday, Susan St. James and Mike Farrell in a comedy movie about single parents and their search for that new perfect relationship. Sex and the Single Parent at 9, 8 Central and Mountain.
First down, New York Jets on their own 23-yard line. There's no score. 4:30 to play in the first period. Todd, Long, and Durkin are the backs. And that's Kevin Long, South Carolina, in his third year. Steady plugger, good blocker. He's downed on the Jet 25-yard line. It'll be second down 8.
They're playing Wesley Walker very tight on the line of scrimmage by Luther Bradley, number 27. Don't be surprised to see something deep on this left side to where they're playing Wesley Walker, number 85.
Right at the line of scrimmage, he gets away. Now Todd throws the bomb deep to the tight end, Mickey Schuler. Jerome Barkham is injured today, and Schuler's in there, and they were trying to hit him deep down the middle. And Doug Jones, 4 years with Buffalo, who did not survive the Bills' last cut, then was picked up by the Lions, was covering on that play.
You know, one thing that you have to be careful of when you have a guy like Walker is that you assume they're going to cover him. Sometimes when they double cover him, But in spite of that, he's so fast that he outruns the double coverage, and you got to get the ball to him as many times as you possibly can during the course of a football game because he's a game breaker.
Williams and Ellis go in the secondary. Two linebackers, Cole and Weaver, come out. Third and eight for the Jets. There's a deep toss. That's way over the head of the receiver, Wesley Walker. No chance for connection on that, and some boos are ringing out now for Richard Todd as he goes over to the New York Jet, and in the punt will be Chuck Hangtime Ramsey. And take a look at his foot. He is a barefooted kicker from Wake Forest. Back as a double safety. For the Lions are Thompson and Ellis. And this is not a very good kick. We'll have to have a bounce, and it takes a Lion bounce. And it's going to be dead on the Lion 48-yard line. All right, the Lions will take over. Good operating position with the score, nothing, nothing.
I've got some very exciting news for you. Hertz just came out with new economy fares. Economy fares mean you can rent a subcompact for only $14.95 a day, weekends, $99 a week with free mileage. We have Fairmonts and Granadas too, also for low prices. And we even have luxurious Thunderbirds for only dollars more a day, all with free mileage. Hertz economy fares simply mean you can't afford not to rent from number one.
Remember this when you choose an airline. American was first with computerized reservations to answer your calls faster.
We were first with curbside baggage processing to handle your luggage faster.
And we were first with one-stop check-in to get you through the airport faster. We're American Airlines, and finding ways to serve you better is one of the things we do best.
We're American Airlines, doing what we do best.
It's a big Sunday here on CBS. Not only our first NFL doubleheader, but Mike Morley, Dan, and Harry are back with television's most shining hour with three brand new stories. You won't want to miss the season premiere of the most watched broadcast of its kind in television, 60 Minutes, here on CBS, right after NFL football.
Let's see if they sense Fred Scott in motion. He's on a slot, and it'd be a good time to throw to him on first down to take advantage of what they're getting over on that side.
There he goes, Scott, 87.
There he goes.
Play action. The pass is complete to the tight end, and he's a dandy. That is David Hill. That's the 11th catch of the season already for David Hill.
Fred Scott did go in motion to the left. Comlo is back into the pocket looking for the tight end. David Hill, 81. They like to throw patterns underneath to him. He's a great receiver. He caught 10 passes going into the game. That's number 11.
It is second down, five to go. Lions on the Jet, 44. Veteran Gene Washington is in. Missed all last year with an injury and has had a hamstring pull this season. He's number 18. Great fake by Comlo. Boy, that was a real fake. He had everybody looking for that ball up the middle, and he rolled out on the bootleg, and Bobby Jackson drove him out.
It's hard to tell whether he actually did that purposely. I don't think he was done purposely. I think he missed the handoff. It didn't get it all the way into the pocket. He wisely, however, kept it, ran to the outside, ran out of bounds, which is also very bright for this young quarterback. And he makes a nice gain out of a busted play.
If that was a busted play, it should be put in.
Yes, I mean, but it wasn't. It definitely was a busted play.
Yeah, he was watching the fullback, really. Leonard Thompson now is in the lineup, number 39 in the white man. Here's Hill in motion. First down, Dexter Bussey. Bussey jammed up and dropped on the 36 of the Jets by Joe Klecko, who is the best pass rusher and a good man against the run from Temple, a heavyweight fighter in college.
You know, as you watch this Jet defense, Gastineau, the defensive left end, is a good pass rusher, but not extremely good against the run. And on the right side, Marty Lyons is extremely good against the run, not especially good against the pass. Let's see how they operate and what they try to do against these young people to take advantage of their skills or lack of skills.
Second down, nine. Lions on the Jet, 36, no score. 2:13 to play in the first period. Gene Washington back in the game. That's Scott in motion. Quick look at David Hill, the tight end, and he's close to the first down. Just the old-fashioned little look-in pass right across the hill.
You see Scott going in motion, and Hill gets a free release off the line of scrimmage. The young quarterback, Homelow, knocks the ball right at the numbers. Sanders makes the catch, and that's kind of a ball, must be thrown at the numbers. If you throw it too high, it's liable to be deflected and wind up being an intercepted pass. A good-looking play from the quarterback to the tight end, Dave Hill.
First down, Lions on the Jet 27. Thompson back in as a wide receiver. That's the rookie, Bo Robinson, to the 24-yard line of the Jets, tackled by another rookie, Stan Blinka. Both teams have starting rookie middle linebacker. Eddie Cole for the Lions and Stan Blinka for the Jets.
And when you talk about the defense of the New York Jets, talking about the secondary, I think basically everybody in the league feels the Schaefer Suggs, the strong safety 23, Burgess Owens 22, are excellent against the run, not as good against the pass, and the people that you want to work on in the secondary are the corners.
They're using wide receivers as messenger men right now for the Lions. Washington needs to play in. Uh-oh. Flags are down. Somebody either got drawn offside or the Jets were offside.
It was either Monty Lyons or Joe Klecko. One of the two looked like they were offside. Let's see what they call. Somebody on the right side was premature and jumped before the ball was snapped. Let's see what they call.
That's offside against the Jets. And that will move the ball to the Jet 19. As they mark it off, the Lions in possession. Deepest penetration of the game.
Offside defense, right side of the line. Still second down.
They had a blitz coming, a double blitz. And evidently the young quarterback changed the rhythm of the count, and that's what made him jump.
They said the right side of the line, they weren't exaggerating.
Exactly right.
Thompson brings the play in. Second down, two to go. Lions ball, the Jet 19. He'll pass on second down. Throws it deep in the end zone to Hill. Over his head, it hit the crossbar. Hill was out there, had his man beaten, but the pass was too deep for him. He ran out of room in the end zone.
When the young quarterback, Homelow, goes back into the pocket, the tight end, Dave Hill, runs a post pattern. He releases the ball, but throws it over the top. Hill really had a step on the defensive back. It had to be a perfectly thrown ball, but it wasn't. Wisely, if you're going to be wrong when you throw a pass, you better be wrong long than short.
Now the Lions have a third and two on the Jet 19. There's no score. 37 seconds to go in the first period here at Shea Stadium. Third and two, one setback. You'll pass for it. Right over the middle it goes. It's complete to Scott on a slant pattern, and he's hit by Stan Blinka, number 54. But the Lions have a first down.
They were in a triple wing formation on the left side, which means the three receivers were over there. Scott came across the middle underneath the linebackers. They're doing a good job of the routes of the pattern because they're trying to throw high percentage passes for the young quarterback. That was right on the money to Fred Scott. He makes the catch. And the Lions have possession, first and 10.
On the Jet 13, they bring a play in for the rookie Comlo. Lawrence Gaines checks in for Bo Robinson, fullback. And there is the end of the first period at Shea Stadium here in Flushing, New York. A scoreless game.
Some guys never learn. They're still taking it on the chin. Gotcha. Norelco offers the Norelco Rotary Razor. Not one or two blades, but 36 blades inside three adjustable floating heads and a unique shaving angle for a very close shave without a nick or cut. So say hello to the Norelco Rotary Razor and say goodbye to Gotcha.
It's my best motor oil, Sunoco Special. Heck, you can take this 10W40 grade, do a lot of hard driving, and it'll stay a 40 grade. Now that's an oil you can count on.
I can be very friendly, yes I can. Catch you with kindness, that's my plan.
give you every courtesy. That's what friendly is to me.
I can be very friendly, very friendly.
Yes, I can.
Next Saturday on the CBS Sports Spectacular, don't miss the Great American Truck Race, when over 20 big 10-wheel diesel rakes battle for the checkered flag. Then from 10 wheels to 4 wheels on the U.S. Roller Skating Championship. You'll say, you saw it on CBS Sports.
CBS Sports Spectacular next Saturday at 4 p.m. The Great American Truck Race and the U.S. Amateur Roller Skating Championships, Part 2 on CBS. Right here on CBS, NFL football, the Lions and the Jets. This is Kurt Gowdy with Hank Stram as we open the second period. The Lions are on the move. They have the ball on the Jet 13-yard line. A first down. And the Lions had the better of it in the first period.
Well, the big difference really so far is the fact that they got a bad kick. Talking about the New York Jets, and the Lions are had very good field position. They're taking advantage of it. Now the point is whether they can take advantage of it by getting 7 or 3 points on the board, preferably, of course, 7.
Bo Robinson and Dexter Bussey are the backs behind rookie Jeff Conlow. That's off to Robinson, just a yard or two. That hole was quickly plugged up there by the middle linebacker Stan Blinka and also Greg Buddle.
Greg Buddle is really number 51, an outstanding defensive linebacker. And of course, their young middle linebacker, Stan Blinka, they like very much also, and they drafted him 5th in the 1979 draft.
These two teams have met only one time before, Thanksgiving Day, 1972, and the Lions beat the Jets 37-20 at Tiger Stadium. This is the first time the Lions have ever played in Shea Stadium. Gaines is in the backfield for the Lions now. Second down, 9 on the Jet 12-yard line. Lions in possession. David Hill in motion. Fake, play action pass. Big rush on, incomplete to David Hill, who thinks he was interfered with by Greg Buddle, the left linebacker. But the officials say no. And a big pass rush by the two rookie defensive ends, Gastineau, 99, and Lyons, the number one draft pick, number 93.
You know, I'm surprised. They set Scott in motion that time, or he was on the left side, I should say, and they tried to lick him on a post flag. But they didn't have enough room. That's the first time they tried to do that, and they need more room to run that kind of a play on their young defensive back, Johnny Lynn, number 29.
Third down and 9. Washington's in there. Bo Robinson back in. Third and 9. Everybody's out. That pass is complete. Touchdown. A great grab by the tight end, David Hill, who has stepped right in behind Charlie Sanders to continue the tremendous tight end tradition of the Lions.
All right, here we see him again. A nice looking play. Schaefer Suggs, number 23. The strong safety is covering on the play. He's a step behind. And Conlow puts the ball right on the numbers. A perfectly thrown ball to David Hill, who makes the reception. They go ahead 6-0.
All right, the Lions have scored with 14:08 remaining in the first half. A 12-yard pass from Conlow to tight end David Hill. Benny Ricardo for the point. And it is up. It is good. We'll be back with a kickoff here at Shea Stadium in New York. Score, Lions 7, Jets nothing.
If we could take you through the plant to show you what is new and let you see what's going on and watch the things we do.
If you could see the cars and trucks we're working on for you, you'd say incredible. Ford, that's incredible.
If you knew how much money we're spending every day for factories and people to help us find the way.
If you could see tomorrow it looks to us today, you'd say incredible. Ford, that's incredible. Ford, that's incredible.
Introducing the incredible Ford Factory Tour. Come and see the things we're doing to rethink, redesign, reshape the automobile. Incredible things to produce a new generation of more fuel-efficient cars and trucks.
If you could see tomorrow,
like the tour.
Incredible!
Say incredible! Ford, that's incredible!
To take the incredible Ford factory tour, write us for information.
This is a possession playbook plan they've got in here. Look at 10 plays to run only 49 yards. Possession passing by the kid Comlo.
Well, it's a good design by the coaching staff. I think Monty Clark and his staff have done a great job of utilizing high percentage passes for this youngster not to get involved with a problem interception.
That's Troy finding a brief opening, flashing over the 35 and getting out to the jet 37. And he ran into Baker down there covering the kickoff. Here's the score. The Colts lead the Browns in the first period, 7-3. Oh, the Jets ball.
37.
They're on 37, first down. Going into 79, the Jets were the youngest team in years of experience in the National Football League, averaging only 3.4 years of experience. The Lions were the fifth youngest team in the entire league. Fake, play action pass. The bound right down to Walker. He's got it. Walker's on the way, and he's hit and dropped. That's two long ones that Wesley Walker has caught. Boy, what a receiver he is.
He's a flyer. Play action pass, a good call. Play action pass, the mesh between a fullback and a quarterback was really not very good. But he sees Walker. The important thing is sees Walker breaking into the middle area. The ball is right on the money. And he is sandwiched in there by Johnny Allen, or Jimmy Allen, I should say, number 40, and he makes the tackle.
All right, up to the line of scrimmage is Richard Todd. His club has a first down now on the Lions 16. That was a 47-yard pass play to Wesley Walker. And they stay on the ground this time. Scott Durkin bangs over the 15 and goes to the 12 or 13-yard line of the Lions. He is hit there by the veteran linebacker, Charlie Weaver. Young linebackers for the Lions. The left linebacker, Brooks, is a rookie. The middleman, Cole, is a rookie. The number two draft pick in back of Cole, Ken Fantetti of Wyoming, is a rookie. Three of their top four linebackers are rookies. 13-yard line of the Lions, second down, 7 for the Jets.
If they run this time, they should run left. No.
And at the 10, and charging is Kevin Long, number 33, to the 9-yard line. Eddie Cole's there, along with Doug English, the right tackle. That Cole, time, the rookie linebacker.
Excuse me, Kurt. That time they ran right into the strength of the defense. It was an undershifted defense with an extra person on the right side of the offensive right, but they preferred to run there anyhow. Did a good job of moving off the line of scrimmage, and you have to give credit to Alexander and Powell on the right side for doing a good job of making things happen.
They get some big horses in there now. Clark Gaines is in there, and a couple of tight end Walker's out. They're 3rd and 3. They're running. And they have the first down. That is Scott Durkin over the 5 to give the Jets a 1st and goal to go. And he ran into Charlie Weaver.
Randy Rasmussen, the left guard, pulled on the play, number 66. Scott Durkin, watch Rasmussen's block, a nice looking block on the play. Durkin does a good job of running inside and is finally tackled there by Eddie Cole, along with Luther Bradley on the play.
All right, the Jets are up. Long, Durkin set behind Richard Todd. 1st and 4 to go for a touchdown. Lions ahead. Slanting over. Kevin Long scores. Long off the left side. Had a great block by Chris Ward there and Randy Rasmussen.
Left shot, off tackle. There you see him. Kevin Long does a good job of running into the pile. Rasmussen, number 66, was also involved in the play. Number 50, Eddie Cole, made the tackle, but it was too late. Touchdown, New York Jets.
Well, the Jets didn't waste any time coming back, and it was a 47-yard pass from Todd to Wesley Walker that set it up. The kick by Lay is good, and we have a tie game here at Shea Stadium. A 63-yard drive in 5 plays, and the Jets now will kick off to the Lions. It's tied 7-all.
A Super Bowl stealer is tough to beat. But against the stealer, I can't compete.
When a Steeler gets hit, it's got the guts to bounce back.
You turkey.
Uniroyal presents the Steeler Radial. It's built tough with two steel belts, and it's tough to beat when you look at its price.
To get to this year's Super Bowl, I'll just surround myself with four tough Steelers.
The Uniroyal Steeler. You want a tough tire at a price that's fair? You want Uniroyal there.
Selling an insurance policy is one thing, but giving you good service is another. And State Farm agents can do that. Whether it's your life, health, home, or car insurance, the information you need is right at our fingertips. If you have a claim, your agent will get it started for you. Fast, friendly, good neighbor service. That's State Farm.
For your life, your health, your home, and your car. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Next Saturday on CBS, 5 p.m., the Woodward Stakes. A one-hour live presentation from Belmont Park in New York featuring some of today's best thoroughbreds. 5 p.m. next Saturday on CBS. Pat Lay will kick off. Rick Kane, 32. Ken Kellicut, 31, are deep for the Lions. And that kick is into the end zone. And it is a touchback. Now the Lions will have the ball on their own 20 with a first down. Jeff Comlow and a quarterback. There's Lay, place kicker for the Jets. Warm day here, Henry, and it's getting warmer as the afternoon moves on. Depth reserves may be a big factor here in the second half.
You're right, because the sun is very hot and the humidity's kind of high.
Lions on their 20. Robinson, the fullback. 2 yards is all. Joe Pellegrini took him, the left tackle, and the middle linebacker, Stan Blinka.
Joe Pellegrini, number 77, the left tackle, is very good against the run, does not get off the line of scrimmage extremely well or rush the passer very well, but it's very difficult to run at him consistently. That time they looked like they tried to run a trap play and didn't succeed in making much yardage on the play.
Rick Kane goes in, 32, replacing Bussey. He's a darter, Kane, his third year. Washington brought the play in. Second down, 8 for the Lions. Own 22.
Counter play.
Back to go to Robinson. And wham! He's down to the line of scrimmage by Greg Buddle. And the Jets are fired up after being scored on first. They came back with a quick score, and now they're stopping Detroit. Third down, 8, Hank.
One thing about Buddle, he's a very bright, intelligent player. Very difficult to run counters, reverses, and screens on him because he reacts, and responds to what he sees so well.
The Jets get a fifth back into the lineup. Take out the linebacker, Blinka. Third down and 8 for the Lions from the 22. Pamo under the gun, now steps up in that pocket, shakes away. He's up to the 23, and he's down to the 22. In there on him is number 58, Mark Merrill. Merrill, number 58.
Here he goes back into the pocket. He was looking to hit the tight end again, David Hill. Looks like steps up in a pocket nicely, runs away from traffic, breaks to the left side. He's got the ball in the wrong arm. He should have the ball in his left arm to protect himself, but he finally tackled. Kicking situation.
Swider in punt formation. Larry Swider. Harper is the safety man on the Jet 40-yard line. No wind. Nice high spiral, but good hang time on this one. Harper on the 36 of the Jets. And he's up to the 39 or 40, and that's it. That was 5 seconds hang time for Swider. Really had it up there. So we'll be back here in Shea Stadium, New York, as the Jets take over with a score tied 7-7.
4-8.
30 years ago, on a hot summer's day, your father taught you how to dig for clams. Now that it's a job, the sun seems hotter and the day longer, but the clams taste just as sweet. And now comes Miller time. Time to head for the best-tasting beer you can find. America's quality beer, Miller High Life.
If you've got the time,
if you've got the time,
we've got the beer,
Miller Beer.
Head and Shoulders doesn't have it. Selsun Blue doesn't have it. Only Denerex has it. An extra relief medicine to stop dandruff itch. You can feel it tingle.
All three have one medicine for dandruff itch, but only Denerex adds a second medicine, an exclusive anti-itch medicine many dermatologists recommend.
You can feel it tingle. That's extra relief medicine, and only Denerex has it.
Denerex stops dandruff itch with extra relief medicine no leading shampoo has.
Next Saturday, see the 1979 Woodward Stakes live from Belmont Park, USA. You saw it on CBS Sports.
Here's a corrected score. It's the Colts 10, Cleveland nothing. They have been held scoreless. They're in the second period at Cleveland.
You know, if I were the New York Jets, I would come right back with a similar play that I started the series with the last time. You got to get the ball to Wesley Walker.
Wesley Walker's flank to the right. Play action pass. They're looking for him. There it goes to him. He's got it. He's at the 40-yard line of the Lions and down to the 38. You're right, Coach Stram.
They ran the same play to the right this time. A play action pass, faking the ball to Kevin Long. Walker goes down and inside. They're doubling him on the outside, so the middle has to be wide open. It is wide open. Finally tackled there by Jimmy Allen, number 40, but he makes another big game.
Wesley Walker has caught three passes in this game, a total of 97 yards. You know, 100 yards a game receiving for a receiver is a hallmark of excellence, just like a running back. Walker's on his way to a 200-yard game if he keeps it up. We'll be back at Shea Stadium. A tie game, 7-7.
Look what's happened to home heating and air conditioning costs. Up and up. Up over 80% in 5 years. But there's a way you can fight back in your attic. Add another layer of pink Owens Corning fiberglass insulation. Ask your dealer or contractor how much more you need. Fight back against rising fuel costs. Get Owens Corning fiberglass insulation now. It's cheaper than oil.
You're seeing some real tough truck pounding. At Ford's Arizona Proving Ground, we've been testing body and suspension components over a tough durability course for more than 20 years. Truck jarring bumps, mud bats, salt bats, frame twists, uphill poundings. And Ford pickups with twin I-beam suspension are built tough to take it. See all the tough Ford pickups at your Ford dealer now. During Ford Truck Week.
Number 85, Wesley Walker, who's been the pass-catching star of this game, averaging 24 yards a catch last year, has one eye, legally blind in his left eye, born that way. And you say, well, it bothers peripheral vision, but he's evidently been able to compensate. He can see anything over either shoulder, and this young fella has a tremendous future ahead, just his third year with the Jets, University of California, Berkeley.
And he's got very soft hands. He catches everything and catches a lot of balls at the end, at the tip, the backside of the football as it's going through.
First down, Jets in the Lion 38. Early in the second period. Cutting back is Harper, who's the quickest back that the Jets have, Bruce Harper. From Kutztown State, Pennsylvania. 5'8", 177, not too big, so they use him as a spot player.
You know, that I formation is a great formation for Harper because all you have to do is point him in the right direction and any kind of a seam, because he has his shoulder square to the line of scrimmage when he cuts up field, he can break in any direction, which he did that time. It was designed to go outside. He went inside and made 9 yards of the play.
Ken Sanders has replaced Bill Gay at defensive left end.
See if they run left.
Second down, six. There's a flag down. Breaking through is Clark Gaines, number 21, but we had a flag dropped on the play as the ball was snapped. Well, they'll bring this one back, and that's going to be holding against the Jets.
Well, they had a nice hole at the point of attack. That's why they had it, evidently, because there was holding. Chris Ward, the left tackle, and Rasmussen, the left guard, did a good job of blocking at the point of attack. Let's see who they call it on.
holding, takedown, number 72.
That's on Chris Ward.
Chris Ward.
Second holding on Chris Ward, who has been plagued with holding calls throughout the preseason and the regular season, and he's a very perplexed young man, and it has bothered his play. Second down, 16.
There he is.
Out it goes. Walker has it. And he's out of bounds. Wesley Walker has caught his fourth ball. And he's out on the 9-yard line to give the Jets a first and goal.
They were in bump and run that time, which means that the defensive back, Bradley, was right on top of Wesley Walker, which is very dangerous. He just ran right by him on the outside. Really had it covered pretty well, but the ball was thrown perfectly right in his hands. He makes the reception, knocked out of bounds.
There, watch this, a great concentration here now. He watches the ball through the hands right into his own hands. That's the way to concentrate.
It's very difficult to cover him one for one, especially on a bump and run situation. I'm surprised that they were in that coverage with that situation like it was.
He's already caught 130 yards of passes in this game. Big game for him. At the five and into the end zone is Kevin Long. His second touchdown. That one comes 7 yards away, and the Jets take the lead.
A little high diddle diddle right up the middle. It was a trap play with Randy Rasmussen, number 66, making the trap. Kevin Long goes into the end zone. A nice executed play that time. Well designed, well executed.
Long has scored the touchdowns, but the battery of Richard Todd to Wesley Walker has been the important factor for the Jets. Clicking on long passes. Up is the kick, and it is good. A 60-yard drive in just four plays. The Jets are striking quickly when they strike. And so they now have the lead over the Lions by a score of 14-7.
This baby's been from Maine to Malibu, but I don't let her go nowhere without the treatment.
This is no car. This is a legend. And you better believe I give her the treatment.
STP Oil Treatment. Since 1964, over half a billion cans have been sold. No other brand even comes close. So do what millions do. Give your car the treatment from STP.
This sweetheart gets a treat, and this sweetheart gets the treatment.
Here's to good friends. Tonight is kind of special.
How you holding up?
I'm all right.
You want to go for 10 miles?
If we make it, I'll buy you a beer.
If we make it, I'll buy you a loan, bro.
When you want the taste of a truly great American beer, tonight, let it be Löwenbräu.
Tonight, let it be Löwenbräu.
It's the World Series of Golf, September 29th and 30th. World-class players shoot it out for the title in the World Series of Golf. You'll say you saw it on CBS Sports.
Top pros in the game will be shooting for top honors. The World Series of Golf on CBS, Saturday, September 29th, Sunday, September 30th. Tom Watson, Bobby Green, Andy Beam, Hale Irwin, Lee Trevino expected to compete. Watch the World Series of Golf. Pat Lay kicking off to either Rick Kane or Ken Calicut. It is coming to Kane on the 8th. Now he picks it up to the 10. And down he goes at the 15-yard line. He got himself in real trouble with a fumble, and he's hit there by Tom Newton, a reserve running back on the kick team. There's the story of the Jet drive, just five plays and 60 yards.
Paul Darby that time, number 84, got down and covered the kick nicely, but didn't make the tackle. Should have made it as soon as he started his course upfield.
Now the Lions in poor field position. They have Dexter Bussey back in there along with Bo Robinson. Your goal is always to try and contain the other team, the kick receiving team, within its 20. When you've done that, that's one of the 10 goals a coaching staff tries to do in a game. Pommel fell down as he tripped over his own feet as he tried a handoff. And the Lion attack now is sputtering and stalling. 54 in on the play.
Straight ahead play, straight ahead shot. With no place to go, Robinson is running, trying to run through the cavity that time that was not there. And the right side of the defensive line did a great job. Joe Klecko and also Marty Lyons.
That's Jimmy Allen, safety man of the Lions, who seems to be hurt. Second down 10. Lions ball their own 16. They're trailing 14-7. 6:34 to go in the first half. Tomlo puts it up. He has a man wide open, Freddie Scott, who skips out of bounds. And he's out on the 26-yard line. That's good for a Lion first down. Jackson and Suggs couldn't stop him.
You know, when they send the receiver in motion, right or left, the corner runs with him. That time, Bobby Jackson, 40, runs all the way across the field, gets a lot of depth. For that reason, throwing in front of him should be very effective. Either right or left, you got two young people on the corners, and they ought to be able to take better advantage than they have so far in this game against these two young defensive backs.
Tomlo has completed 6 out of 9. The Lions have 5 first downs. The Jets have 9 first downs. First down, Lions on their 26. Hit at the line of scrimmage. And downed is Bo Robinson, the rookie fullback. And Joe Klecko got to him there. Klecko, number 73. Here's a score. The Eagles over New Orleans, 10-0 in the second period. New Orleans is yet to win. The Eagles are 1-1. Horace King, 25, replaces Bo Robinson in the Lion backfield. So on the Lion 25, second down 11. When they throw the ball, they're using a short possession type passing game.
See if they send Scott in motion to the left side this time. See what happens. No, they didn't.
Flags are down. Tomlo is sacked by Mark Gastineau, 99, the rookie left end.
Marty Lyons, number 93, was offside on the play. 93 right in. Marty Lyons was offside.
He is the number one pick from Alabama for the Jets. That's it. He was the best player that the national champs had last year.
Here you see him going offside prematurely. Evidently, the catch disturbed him a little bit, but he was offside, and luckily so for the Detroit Lions.
Well, that wiped out the Jets sack. The Jets are not getting to the quarterback. That's why they have those two youngsters in there starting today at ends, defensive ends, Gastineau and Lyons, and they were down and around the bottom of the league last year in getting to the quarterback.
I think one thing definitely that Detroit has to do, they must throw the ball more on first down.
93. The second down.
Especially when they send their people in motion. They have all the room in the world in front of their defensive backs. They've thrown to him one time on the outside. He was open. They should do more of that, especially on first down.
We'll watch for it, Hank. 5:40 to play and a half. Lions ball are on 31, second and 6. The Jets are leading 14-7.
See if he goes in motion here this time.
That's Scott in motion. They go out to Scott. The screen. Scott banged down short of a first down by Greg Buttle, who played that one well, number 51. You know, that's Scott from Amherst.
You know, that time the defensive back, Bobby Jackson, slipped and fell. Had they thrown the ball downfield on the outside, there wouldn't have been anybody near. Luckily for the Jets, they threw the ball short. By the time they got the ball out there, they recovered, responded, and made the tackle. But again, they can do that anytime they want to. Curtis, really open.
Voice you're listening to is Hank Stram, former coach, Kansas City Chiefs, New Orleans Saints, and a man who in his career one of the best records of professional coaching.
Watch the tight end come in motion this time to the left. Here he comes.
That's David Hill, the tight end. Play action pass. They're going to Hill, and he's down there, and he can't hold on to it. They had a big man against a little man that time. Schaefer Suggs back trying to cover David Hill. Suggs is a tough player in that secondary. He's a hard hitter.
Yes, he's a very good tackler, not a good cover guy. That time the ball was thrown a little bit too short, and sometimes that kind of a pass is a very effective one because the defensive back goes beyond and you're able to catch it. He almost made the catch on the play.
Swider will kick to Harper. Last time Swider hung the punt up 5 seconds. 4.5 is considered good. Hanging up there to give coverage time. This is the low kick. Harper runs up, takes it on the 35 to the 40. And his forward motion stopped at his 43-yard line. Boy, that's a dangerous punt, that low spiral.
2-7 that time.
Yeah.
Looked like a trolley line going down there that time, Kurt.
Ken Fantetti, the rookie from Wyoming, went down to cover. Big night on CBS, 60 minutes. The Sunday, right over the middle, and it's complete. An excellent catch there. Bobby Jackson making the hit. Boy, that's hard when you're slanting over that middle. And look at the Comlo being decked here.
Yes, he got rid of the ball nicely. Reads the defense well, good anticipation. Throwing a ball out in front on the play. Good reception. First and 10.
That's the sixth catch for Freddie Scott.
Number 87. It was a second down situation. I'm sorry.
Second down. Nine to go. Lions on their 44. The pass is complete to Bo Robinson, who's back in at fullback. He's not out of bounds. Greg Middle wrapped him up. Buttle stopped him on the 47. Just a 3-yard gain for the Lions, and they're down to a third and six. We're in the last 1 minute and 20 seconds of the third period, and the Lions are trailing the Jets 17-7.
It's really difficult to do very much business on Craig Buttle, number 51, the left linebacker. As I mentioned earlier, he really reads in response to what he sees very, very well.
Gene Washington and Scott are in a slot left. Third and six. Everybody looking for the pass. The blitz is on. David Hill. He caught the ball. Hill caught the ball. And he got up and started to run. What an amazing catch by David Hill. Caught it on his back. Blitz here. Watch the blitz.
Here it comes. Up the middle. Come on. Throws it falling away like throwing a hand grenade, but he gets it underneath. Watch the concentration by Hill.
Oh, what a catch.
Unbelievable catch by David Hill, number 81, the tight end.
Here's the angle. A lot of people might have thought that he was tripped up here. There might have been some interference call, but no flag was thrown, Henry.
No, he was trying to come back. As I mentioned earlier in the game, sometimes you throw the ball short, the receiver can come back and make the catch. That's what happened there.
All right, the Lions are threatening in the last 7 seconds of the third period. First down to the Jet 29. Here's a reverse to Scott, 30. A hit out of bounds on the Jet 26. And there's a gun. And the end of the third quarter at Shea Stadium in Flushing, New York. The Lions are on the move, and the score is the Jets 17 and the Lions 7. Now pause for a word from your local station.
CBS presents Sidney Sheldon's powerful bestseller of four lives shattered by a woman's revenge. The Other Side of Midnight, Tuesday at 8, 7 Central and Mountain. This is CBS.
Entertaining night, CBS, 60 minutes back with a brand new season of brand new stories. Then Carol Burnett faces a difficult, dramatic decision on the 10th month. And all in the family. Slave driver Archie pushes Edith too far. It's on CBS tonight. We're into the fourth period at Shea Stadium. This is Kurt Gowdy with Hank Stram. And as we pick up the first play from scrimmage of this period, the Lions have the ball on the Jet 26, second down 7. Jeff Comlo, the rookie, 17 out of 22, 153 yards. Todd is 6 out of 10, 150 yards. Lions trying to get back in now. Grab a touchdown. Culminate this drive. Rick Kane is in at running back. And the drive goes over the 25 to the 24-yard line. And it was carried by Bo Robinson, the fullback, where he was spun down by Stan Blinka and Lawrence Pillars, the left end.
That was really a good call because they tried to trap the defense. They had a middle linebacker, Blinka, playing a little deep that time. They thought they maybe could pop the seam with a trap, but they didn't succeed in doing it. But I think basically it was a good call.
Hey, here's a tough call. Third and 5, and you're behind by 10. And you're on the other club's 24-yard line.
They'll send the tight end in motion here. Let's see if they do this. 81. Here he comes.
Hill in motion to tight end. And they get the ball to Hill. They tried it, and it's broken up. And a flag is down. Burgess Owens broke it up, number 22, and a flag is down. Maybe interference.
Hill went in motion and came across the middle. Really didn't run a very good pattern at all. And Burgess Owens, number 22, they declare Let's see what they call here. Evidently pass interference.
I don't know. Maybe a holding call or a legal check. Not interference.
Holding, number 40, 5 yards, first down.
Away from the ball, holding call on the left cornerback, Bobby Jackson. That's an automatic first down and a good break for the Lions, who have had a couple of bad breaks that they made for themselves with fumbles in the fourth, third period. Lions ball, first down on the Jet 19-yard line. Cracking him much on the ground. A yard pickup. Joe Klecko makes the hit on Bull Robinson. We've had one sack by the Jets in the game, two sacks by the Lions. They've both been by Bubba Baker, who finally recorded his first sacks of the year. Two turnovers, both charged to the Lions, and the Jets have played flawless ball in turning the ball over.
Yeah, Scott, anchored on the left side, has a lot of room, had a lot of room on Lind, but they elected to run the football.
Second down, 10. Lions on the Jet 19. Scott in motion. Wide open and a pass thrown badly to Rick Kane. He had a big rush on him. 99, Gastineau was in there on him. Mack Merrill was out to cover. They're trying to get the back on the linebacker. A hard rush, though, that time. They like to get 3 or 4 yards deep, then get those arms up. And then it's tough to throw.
Yes, it is. And that time, Rick Lane had the linebacker beaten on the play. He just threw it poorly.
Third and 9, third and 10, 19-yard line. Yep, the Lions 6 out of 11 on third down conversion, which is good. 40% is about average. Error. Kane fell down, number 32, circling out there. He was covered by Greg Buddle, and Kane said, "Hey, I was tripped up." But the officials say no. Lawrence Pillars put another hard rush that time on the quarterback, Comlo. Though it's fourth down, and Benny Ricardo will commit to try a field goal. Larry Swider will hold for him. This should be a 36-yard attempt for Benny Ricardo, who's had two attempts this year and one of them successful. This kick is up, up, and it is good. Ricardo boots a 36-yard field goal. Well, the Lions pick up a field goal early in the fourth period. When we come back to action at Shea Stadium, it's the Jets 17 and the Lions 10.
There's a paper explosion going on. It's an insurmountable problem. But Federal Express has an easy solution. We can take the paper that has to get somewhere fast and take it off your back. Documents, contracts, reports, whatever. So for as little as $16, we can pick up the stuff on your desk and have it cleared across the country on somebody else's desk overnight. Federal Express, when it absolutely, positively has to be there overnight.
How long do you want your car to last?
Forever. Now, don't laugh. She's already gone over 90,000 miles and without a major engine repair. I try to take good care of her. I give her regular checkups, and the only motor oil I ever use is Quaker State.
Quaker State can't promise everyone mileage like Mr. Miles gets, but Quaker State helps cars last, and that's a fact.
Guess that's why Quaker State's the best-selling motor oil in America.
Ricardo will kick off. The throw-in Samoan didn't throw, but he ran 14 yards for a touchdown. The number one draft pick of the Bengals, Jackie Thompson of Washington State. New England 14, Cincinnati 7, late in the third period. Ricardo's kick. Bruce Harper, Ken Schroyer back.
You got it, Kenny, you got it!
Short to Schroyer, 16 to the 20. 25, finds a hole, 35, 40, and out to the 48-yard line. Ben Schroy. Down in at Minnesota, Dell Williams on a 3-yard one. Vikings 9, Miami 7 with 13 seconds to go in the first half. There's a field goal scoring drive by the Lions. Jackie Thompson, a highly regarded young quarterback, Hank.
Yes, I saw him in preseason. He is a good looking prospect, but remember again, Kurt, he's just a rookie. He ought to be able to throw the ball well.
Kevin Long, a flag is down. Long blasts into Lion territory to the Lion 40. I always get a kick out of you coaches. Remember, Kurt, he's just a rookie. Coaches really don't have a lot of trust in rookies, do they?
Oh, yes, but not at the quarterback position. You can't. It's very difficult to win big, win championships with a quarterback, a rookie quarterback. And it doesn't mean he's not a good prospect, but it's very difficult for him to move in to lead a football team.
Left guard moved early, number 66. Still first down.
Randy Rasmussen, the only player on the Jets squad over 30 years of age, was in motion that time. Cost the Jets five, puts them back to their 43-yard line, and they have a first and 15 to go. They're ahead in the game, 17 to 10. Richard Todd,
there it
is, chased around, and he's sacked. Doug English in there today. English is one man in there. And Purifoy really got the sack. Dave Purifoy from Eastern Michigan. That's the third sack for the Silver Rush. 55 sacks, an all-time club high last year.
They really did a good job of putting pressure on Todd that time, and it's a good thing they did, because Walker ran an inside-outside pattern on Luther Bradley and was open, and had he been able to throw the ball, it would have been a big play.
All right, the Jets have a second down and 25. Line of scrimmage. There's their own 33. Harper and Gaines are the backs. They haven't hit Walker with a pass in this half. Wesley Walker. He's streaking out. He falls down. The pass goes to Harper. Harper gets some of the yardage back. He's upended in the Shea Stadium infield of the Mets on his own 48-yard line by James Hunter, number one draft pick in 76 for the Lions.
What you saw on that last play was the best way in the world to prevent Wesley Walker from catching the ball. They knocked him down as he came across the middle, and that's the best way, because it was very difficult for him to get up in time and get back into the pattern.
That's the first pass completion for Richard Todd in the second half. He now has 7 out of 11 for 160 yards. He has used the pass sparingly in this half. Third down, 15. Up out of the pocket. There's the pass to Walker. He has it. Walker's out of bounds on the 27-yard line. They got it to him. That's the fifth. Let's see. That is the fifth pass he's caught. Big yardage today for him.
There he is. He's bump and run again on the left side. Todd does a good job of stepping up into the pocket, but there's no way in the world. You've got to get the ball to Wesley Walker. He ran the same pattern I mentioned he ran just a play or two ago, in and out, turned Bradley around, and was open behind. Big play.
A 30-yard pass play. Figure his average out, Bobby. Walker's best day in a Jet uniform has been 178 yards against Oakland. He has caught 159 yards today against the Lions. Gerking, 25. Gerking pounds it to the 21 of the Lions. 6-yard gain. His second down, 4. And he's hit there by Doug English. Now the Jets are threatening. They're trying to hold on to a 17-10 lead with 11:24 to play.
That was a counter play with a fullback hitting in the middle area. Randy Rasmussen, the left guard, 66. And incidentally, the only player remaining from the Super Bowl team. Pullen did a good job on the play.
Walker's averaged only 32 yards a catch today. 32 yards per reception. There's Gaines at the 10. Gaines to the 5. Flags are down. Mark Gaines, number 21, to Wake Forest. Have the first down if the penalty's against the Lions. Face mask called against the Lions. A face mask against the Lions. And the Jets now are in scoring position.
Watch Rasmussen trap. It was a trap play. The time before that, they faked to the fullback, gave it to the halfback. This time, they give it to Clark Gaines, number 21,
foul.
On the trap play.
Face mask, number 46. Half the distance of the goal line, first down.
All right, now Gaines had the face mask called in the Jets' favor. He reached the 5. They penalized the Lions half the distance to the goal. The Jets had the ball in the Lion 2.5-yard line. First and goal to go. Pat to Durkin. Durkin, touchdown. Scott Durkin is over.
And Randy Rasmussen, another trap play. The left guard, Randy Rasmussen, trapping on the play, 66. Scott Durkin sees the running room, lowers the shoulder on Jimmy Allen, number 40, and spins his way into the end zone for the touchdown.
The big play was the 30-yard pass from Richard Todd to Russell Walker. The kick by Leahy is good. Well, the Jets move right back out with another lead that is a little more comfortable. The score, the Jets 24 and the Lions 10.
Thanks, AC.
Americans are learning that if their car's plugs are misfiring, a tune-up with new AC spark plugs can help improve gas mileage.
Thanks, AC.
Now's the time to tune up because AC Delco is making it possible for you to get 8 AC spark plugs for the price of 7.
Thanks, AC.
Tune up with AC. Buy 7. Get one free.
Thanks, AC.
Each year, fire burns more than 1 million acres, threatens lives, and destroys property. To help fight fires, Monsanto developed a fire-retardant chemical made from diammonium phosphate. When mixed with water and sprayed from planes, this chemical coats the forest and slows down the spread of the fire.
No chemical is totally safe all the time, everywhere. But if we want to protect our natural resources, we need chemicals like diammonium phosphate. Without chemicals, life itself would be impossible.
Next Saturday on the CBS Sports Spectacular, don't miss the Great American Truck Race, when over 20 big 10-wheel diesel rakes battle for the checkered flag. Then from 10 wheels to 4 wheels on the U.S. Roller Skating Championship. You'll say, you saw it on CBS Sports.
Two outstanding events, the Great American Truck Race and Amateur Roller Skating Part 2, Trucks and Roller Skates on Sports Spectacular. What a combo. Kane out to the 5. He's to the 20. Flag is down. He's to the 26-yard line. Baltimore and Cleveland are tied 10-all. Brian Sipes, a 35-yard pass to Dave Logan. 4:20 left in the third period. Brian Sipes isn't very pretty to watch, but he's doing a job for the Browns this year.
Yeah, he doesn't have a strong arm, and he's not overly large, but he's very accurate. He's got good timing, good release, and I know Sam Ratigliano likes him very much.
This penalty's going against the Lions. 44-yard field goal by Tony Franklin, the rookie of Texas A&M, and the Eagles lead New Orleans 19-7.
Number 52.
That's blocking below the waist.
First down.
That's the new rule this year on punts, kickoffs. You cannot block below the waist. The idea of that is to try and eliminate some of the knee injuries.
Yes, this isn't a good rule.
Lions ball on their 13-yard line. First down. They're trailing by 14 now. And they give the ball off to Horace King from Georgia, his fifth year. Not much for him. He ran into the fired-up young middle linebacker Stan Blinka and Lawrence Pillars, the left end, from Alcorn State.
You know, the Lions really have had a difficult time with field position almost all afternoon. They've had to come out of the soup. They move the ball once they've got out of that area, but it's been difficult getting out of the 15, 20, 20-yard line, trying to make a march of 80 yards.
Robinson is a short back. Kane is the tailback in the eye. Second down, 8 from the Lions, 15. Hill's in motion. Out it goes to Dave Hill. He's pinned in, and he's stopped. He's hit down there by number 23, Schaefer Suggs. Blinka slowed him up, then Suggs nailed him. Lawrence Pillars also. Suggs coaches a midget baseball team in the offseason. 17-6, the Oilers over the Kansas City Chiefs at halftime. It is third down, 8 to go for the Lions. Lions last year won 1 and lost 6. Then they turned the season around, won 6 of their last 9. We watched them beat San Diego. They were very impressive. The only game San Diego lost in the last 8 games of San Diego's schedule. Third down and 8. Conlow gets away. Pillar throws on the run up the sideline into the Lion bench. Fourth and eight. Lions will have to punt.
David Hill that time did not make any kind of penetration, any kind of a adjustment on the pattern. He ran to the sideline and just stood there instead of going upfield. Pellegrini, number 77, put the pressure on Conlow that time.
They give the Jet defense a hand. The longer I watch this pro football, Hank Stram, the less I understand it. How can a club give up 56 points one week and come back and be leading 24-10 the second week?
The best way to understand it is not to try to figure it out, Kurt, because it's very confusing.
The kick to Harper in the 46. Harper's at the 50. 45 of the Lion. And he's still going to the 40 and takes it to the Lion 38-yard line. This Harper is a tough little monkey the way he runs.
Fantetti really made good contact, but he didn't squeeze him and he got away from him. But Fantetti, number 57, really made good coverage on the punt and should have had the tackle.
Jets ball again in good field position. The score, 24-10, New York Jets.
If we could take you through the plant to show you what is new and let you see what's going on and watch the things we do.
If you could see the cars and trucks we're working on for you, you'd say incredible. Ford, that's incredible.
Introducing the incredible Ford factory tour. Come and see the incredible things we're doing to produce a new generation of more fuel-efficient cars and trucks.
If you could see tomorrow, the way it looks to us today, you'd say incredible. Ford, that's incredible.
To take the incredible Ford factory tour, write us for information.
Wesley Walker's been the man today, the fleet All-Pro wide receiver from the University of California in his third year, has 159 yards in receptions out of 190 for the Jets. There he is, legally blind in his left eye. He has averaged 30 yards a catch today. He's 19 yards away from his all-time career record in one game. Boy, I'll tell you, how fast can he run? He can run as fast as he wants to. Runs a 40 and 4-3. Durkin, 35, Durkin to the 34. How would you compare? Here's a good comparison. Wes Chandler of New Orleans and Wesley Walker of the Jets.
Well, I think Walker, what I've seen of him, has more raw speed, native speed than Chandler. Chandler is more of a, and he's got excellent speed too, but he can be a running back, punt returns, kickoff return. Basically, it's just raw speed.
Good day for Richard Todd. He may have worked himself into that number one spot that he used to hold. Matt Robinson took away after an injury. Harper, 35. Harper turning the corner to the 30, just short of the first down to the 26-yard line of the Lions. Number 40, Jim Allen. Doug Jones, 46. Halftime score, a tight defensive battle. The two bays, the Bay of Florida leading the Bay of Wisconsin, 7-3.
Tampa especially is an excellent defensive team, and Green Bay last week played extremely well in the second half.
They have given the Jets a first down. On the Lion, 26. The score, 24-10, Jets ahead. 8 minutes, 10 seconds to play.
They've been trying to run outside from the wing back position, double wing. Here they come again.
25. Nailed there is Kevin Long. He's hit by number 52, Dave Washington, the outside linebacker, and the right cornerback, Luther Bradley. Number one draft pick last year out of Notre Dame. A good player, solid cornerback.
That time they were in a double wing formation, a flanker to the right side, and Harper on the wing on the left side so as to get a blocking angle on the defensive end, but they didn't do a very good job on the play.
The Colts and the Browns are in the fourth period. I don't know whether Burt Jones is playing in that game or not.
I haven't heard.
We had some communication breakdowns up here in our booth. Second down, 8. Durkin. Durkin to the 20. And he runs it just short of the 15-yard line. The tackle made by number 50, the middle linebacker, Eddie Cole.
That's the old crossbuck again. The left guard pulling Rasmussen on the play. Durkin following his left guard Rasmussen, 66, does a good job of finding running room, taking advantage of it. Nothing fancy. Good two-fisted hard running on the play. A kind of a sledgehammer play, and they make a good gain on the off-tackle smash.
They're going to measure. Durkin, Long have had some hard running out of the jet backfield. Great receiving and throwing by Todd DeWalker has been the story for New York. The Lions are trying to hang in. They have had terrible luck. They lost a very fine young quarterback, Gary Danielson, who brought that club along. Walt Michaels paid that tribute to Danielson. So when you have a kid like that, the way he played the last half of last season, and you lose him, it is discouraging to the rest of the ball club.
Yes, it is. It really is. It's a very difficult thing to overcome.
Third down and inches. The Jets on the Lions 16 with the Jets ahead.
They're going to run right.
Max Graham says they'll go right.
Nope.
The quarterback sneak Todd. Big strong fellow that played the wishbone at Alabama under Bear Bryant. And he has the first down.
That time the tailback or the left halfback was deeper than the fullback, which he does when he does run right. That's why I thought perhaps he might run right on the last play.
All right, Coach Graham, let's have your capsule opinion of Richard Todd as a fourth-year quarterback in the NFL.
Well, I saw him when he first broke into the league, and I sincerely feel that he can be one of the finest quarterbacks in the National Football League. I just don't know how there can be any indecision as to who the quarterback should be of this New York Jet team.
Unquote, Hank Graham. Gaffney in motion. Durkin on the sweep at the 15 and downed at the 13-yard line. The Jets have just been playing bread-and-butter football in the second half, except for that one 30-yard strike to Wesley Walker. They have played very conservatively and trying to hold on to their lead.
Well, going into this football game, they were 2 rushing in the American Football Conference, and it's very easy to understand why they enjoy that level of success, because they're doing a good job of rushing here today. And this is what they like to do. They like to run the ball at you, and now, of course, they're trying to consume as much time as possible by stuffing the ball at the Detroit Lions if they can.
Well, they're in the third period at Bloomington, Minnesota. 9-7, the Vikings leading the Miami Dolphins. The Dolphins won their first 2 games. Vikings are 1-1. Second down, 8. Jets on the Lion 13. That's Kevin Long. Flag is down over the 10. Long has been the leading ball carrier. He's had 65 yards. Durkin has had 51. There's another face mask called against the Lions. That'll be half the distance to the goal.
You know, here we see. There you see the face. There you see the face mask.
That's Sanders, 82.
82 is right.
Personal foul, face mask. Half the distance to the goal line. First down.
You know, one thing impresses me with these two running backs, Durkin and Long, they're journeyman runners. I would say, Kurt, but the great thing about them, they both do a good job of blocking for each other and helping the plays go, and that's very important.
Walker comes out. Gaffney's out. They put tight ends in there. Raba's gone in. Barkham is injured today, Jerome Barkham. First and goal to go. Jets on the line, 5-yard line. And into the end zone for a touchdown. His third touchdown of the game is Kevin Long, the third-year player from South Carolina. He has scored 3 TDs.
They're in a wing-back formation this time. They toss the ball outside. There you see Kevin Long, number 33. He finds some running room inside, puts his head down and his shoulders down. Good running angle, goes into the end zone for the touchdown.
We went into the Jet locker room before the game to say hello to Walt Michaels, the coach. There's the kick by Lay is up. And the Jets now have increased their lead to 31-10. And we'll explain what Michaels had to say about last week's horrendous game. We'll be back here with the Jets increasing their lead.
This is the Sony Betamax, and this is the competition. There's one major difference, the beta tape loading system. It enables us to offer features like Betascan. It's like fast forward and reverse, but you can see what you're looking for and stop when you find it. The fact that the other tape loading system doesn't have Betascan doesn't mean it's a bad system. In fact, it's a very good one. And we should know, because before we invented our system, the beta system, we invented theirs.
Meet the only stealer with a tougher body than mine.
You're looking at one stealer that can dish it out, and one stealer that can take it.
Uniroyal presents the Steeler Radio. It's built tough with two steel belts, and it's tough to beat when you look at its price.
When it comes to keeping his feet, there's only one stealer I can't beat.
The Uniroyal Steeler. You want a tough tire at a price that's fair? You want Uniroyal there.
Tomorrow, Ken Howard returns as the White Shadow, and a Cub reporter pins a gambling rap on Jackson. The White Shadow back for another winning season tomorrow at 8, 7 Central.
Say what?
31-10, the Jets lead. Kevin Long has just tied a record for a Jet running back. He's one of the record holders of it, we'll tell you in a minute. A booming kick by Lay. Kane a yard deep. Out to the 10. The 20, flag is down. And if this is on the Lions, they're killing themselves with penalties right now with face masks, holding. The record for the most touchdowns by a Jet running back is held by Boozer. Three times he did it, against Denver, New England twice. Billy Joe against Boston, and Kevin Long against Buffalo last year. So Long, for the second time in his career, scored three touchdowns in the game.
Hand, number 81 offense.
That's against David Hill. Back the Lions go to their own 10-yard line, and they're trailing now 31-10 with 5:14 to play.
Mike McGibbon, that time number 53, did a good job of covering and making the tackle on the kickoff coverage.
First down. That was the last Jet scoring drive. Freddie Scott in motion. There it is, up in the air for grabs. It was trying to get it to the tight end Hill, but he was surrounded by three green-shirted Jets, and Comlo had a tough pass rush on him also.
It's very obvious that the basic plan going into the game was to try to hit David Hill as much as they possibly could. In the process, however, there are many times where the outside receivers are open, but they don't get the ball thrown to them because I think the quarterback, Comlo, is so concerned about getting the ball to the one receiver that he really doesn't take a look at the secondary receivers, and he hasn't succeeded really in getting the ball outside very well.
Campfield ran 10 yards for an Eagle touchdown. They're burying New Orleans now 26-7 in the fourth period. New Orleans can't stop anybody.
That's amazing. They're a great offensive team, but haven't been able to stop anybody all year long.
Screen pass attempted to Dexter Bussey, number 24. Nothing's working for the Lions now. Another big pass rush, this time by Joe Pellegrini, who really is the slowest man up front for the Jets.
Much better against the run than he is against the pass. And I think, Kurt, that's about the third time that they've thrown that kind of a screen pass in this area of the field during the course of this football game this afternoon.
For late tuners in, the Lions scored first. Dave Hill caught a pass for a touchdown. This is a third down play. Wide open. Freddie Scott, 35-yard line, first down Lion. Then the Jets came back. A big play with a 47-yard pass to Wesley Walker. Long went 4 yards over for a touchdown. Long scored 7-yard run for a touchdown. It was 14-7 at the half. Field goal by Lay. And a field goal by Ricardo. And then a touchdown by Durkin and a touchdown by Long on short run. It's 31-10. Intercepted. Jets ball on the line, 35. And up with that ball right over the middle is number 54, the rookie Stan Blinka.
Yeah, they're trying to hit the tight end again, David Hill. That time, number 18 was wide open, Gene Washington, but he still tried to hit the receiver inside. And the fine young middle linebacker, Stan Blinka, number 54, made the interception.
Oh, I like him. He moves. He's enthusiastic. Walt Michaels said he just got ready before we thought he would. What are you going to do? You can't keep him out of there.
And he's getting better and better with each play.
Jets ball on the Lion, 45. The third turnover of the half against the Lion. The Jets have not committed a turnover in the game. Look out for Walker. Out it goes. They got him again. Walker caught that ball at the 26-yard line. The burning speed of Wesley Walker, but he came back that time on a pivot to come back toward the pass.
Well, there's a play-action pass, and they fake left. And to Gaines, and Walker comes across the middle. They're double covering him on the outside, which means the middle should be open. That time, the Eddie Cole almost deflected the ball, but he didn't.
Walker has now tied his own record for most yards recorded in the game. He has caught 178 yards of passes. Clark Gaines for the 20. Another long bomb to Walker, and he'll pass 200 yards. Warming up on the sideline is Scott Hunter, the veteran, who's been around for the Lions and everybody. Second down, four to go. Jets smelling the kill here now, are pouring it on. They're ahead 31-10. 3 minutes to play. Great handoff. Clark Gaines wriggling to the 17-yard line. Fourth year back from Wake Forest.
Another trap play that time with Randy Rasmussen, number 66, doing the trapping on the play. And again, a trap block is a trap is a play whereby you pretend like you're not going to block the defensive tackle or end and permit him to come across the line of scrimmage and then blocking from the inside out. That's exactly what happened on the last play.
They officially have Walker down now 177 yards, one short of his career record. Third down and a foot to go. Giant, the Jets are running hard today, these backs. They're fighting for that extra yardage.
Good old-fashioned off-tackle play to the right. Nobody pulling. Durking fights through the traffic, sees a little running room, breaks to the inside, and is finally tackled there by Dave Washington, number 52.
That's what you coaches like, that second effort. We'll be back here with a score, the Jets 31, the Lions 10.
A good quarterback does his homework on and off the field. That's probably why the three of us are all drinking light beer from Miller.
See, light's got a third less calories than the regular beer, and it's less filling.
Plus, it tastes great.
And you know it's important to have a command of facts like that.
It's mental discipline, really.
You're darn right.
Because if you know every position, every option, every formation, you'll never get your signals crossed.
Hey, that's my beer, Terry.
Oh, no, this is...
Yeah,
no,
wait,
well,
this is... No,
you big wait a minute.
Light like beer from Miller. Everything you always wanted in a beer, and less.
I didn't peel my label.
Super automotive values from Sears. Dynaglass belted 25 tires are on their way to Sears Tire and Auto Centers. Right now, save $16 to $32 on a set of four. It's a big national truckload sale on Sears' best-selling belted tire. Now get the Sears heavy-duty shock, just $9.99 each installed. Smooth out some of the jolts, jars, and jerks with America's best-selling shock installed only $9.99. At Sears, where America shops for value.
Kurt Gowdy and Hank Stram, New York Jets, on the 9-yard line of the Lions. 2 minutes to play, first and goal. The Jets have racked up two touchdowns in the fourth quarter to just about put the game out of reach. The Lions got a field goal. They got to within 17-10, and then the two Jet touchdowns turned it all around. Trying to give it to Long to get that fourth touchdown. Got three, which would be an all-time Jet record in the game. Just to the 7-yard line, second down, seven. Baker, Bubba Baker on the stop. Defensive rookie of the year last year in the National Conference.
Harper comes in the game. He likes to run outside. Number 42. They got a double tight end situation on the left side. They got 82 over here. Mickey Schuler.
Second and goal. Jets on the Lions' 7-yard line.
There he goes.
Bruce Harper on the sweep, not going anyplace. Stop for no gain. Lions pursued that time. They gang up on him on the 7. It'll be 3rd and 7 to go.
Eric Cunningham that time was in for Randy Rasmussen, number 68. Really got out in front of the ball carrier in good shape.
Chuck Will, our producer. Bob Daly off the United States Tennis Open, back in the old stand where he's been for many years, one of the top directors in the business. And all of our technical gang here at Shea Stadium. Next week, Hank and I move down to the Orange Bowl for the Bears and the Dolphins. Many of you will see the Bears and the Cowboys on the CBS doubleheader with Pat Summerall and Tom Brookshire following this game. 3rd and 7. Clark gains 1 yard, and that's all. 4th and 6 for a Jet touchdown. 18 seconds to play. That's 4th and 5 for a touchdown. So the Jets, last week, the worst defeat in their history, 56-3 by the Patriots, a young team that forgot quickly and bounced back and have scored an impressive win today over the Detroit Lions. Walt Michaels told us in the locker room, hey, these kids are young, and when you're young, you can forget bad days a lot quicker. And that's what we've got to do today, and they did it. They had a good practice week, and they bounced back to get their first win. The Lions are off to a slow start, racked up by injuries, and now are winless in their first 3 games. But remember last year, they lost 6 of their first 7, then came back to win 6 of their last 9.
You have to give Monty Clark and Walt Michaels a lot of credit, really, especially Michaels brought his team back after a humiliating loss last week. But win impressively here. And of course, you have to feel a little sorry for Monty Clark because of the injuries that he's had in his football team.
We'll return to Shea Stadium in Flushing, New York, after this word from your local station.
This is CBS.
Well, the 2 touchdowns in the 4th quarter put it away for the Jets. They win it 31-10. Richard Todd, we said before the game, if he could come up with some kind of a performance today, could reestablish himself as the number 1 quarterback of the Jets. Matt Robinson, the other fellow that has been battling him for the number 1 position, has an injured thumb, and Todd came through today.
Yes, he did, and it wasn't any surprise really to me, Kurt. I've seen him on many occasions. Early in his career before he had the injuries, and there's no question in my mind that he's one of the very fine young quarterbacks in the National Football League. He's got a terrific arm, good composure, good confidence, played with a great university like the University of Alabama, but there's no reason why he shouldn't be one of the outstanding young quarterbacks in the league if he stays healthy.
Not a bad day for outside receiver Wesley Walker. He caught 6 balls, only averaged 29 yards a catch, back to where he usually is. He came into this game with a 13-yard average, but he broke it today, and he'll be right back up there among the reception and the yardage leaders. All right, we'll be back here at Shea Stadium right after this message.
RCA wants you to see the right color. Does your television automatically capture all the subtle shades of difference between this surfer in deep blue, this blue surfboard, and the blue Hawaiian surf? If not, wait till you see color, even color this close, on ColorTrack 1980. PowerTrack 1980, with 8 automatic color systems designed to lock even subtle shades of color on track. RCA is making television better and better.
Take care of your car at Kmart.
Your Kmart Automotive Center has the answer to your muffler problem. The zinc-coated, double-wrapped Kmart Arrestor Muffler. Have it installed by Kmart, and if anything goes wrong, they'll replace it free, as long as you own your American-made car. The Arrestor. Zinc-coated and double-wrapped like the best. And best of all, Kmart price. Get it at Kmart Automotive Centers across the USA, where quality auto products are Kmart priced.
All right, we have Richard Todd, number 14, Wesley Walker, number 85, the battery today for the Jets, Kurt Gowdy and Hank Stram up here in the CBS broadcasting booth. And Richard Todd, must have been a satisfying afternoon for you. You put the Jets in the win column, and the day you had, 9 out of 13, 208 yards passing, should certainly give you a reestablishment there as the Jets' number one quarterback right now.
Well, the most important thing, you know, is for us to get a win. And we should have beat Cleveland the first game, I felt, and we need a win. And plus, I need the confidence, you know, but I'm not talking about myself, I think.
All right, now, the New York Jets game, of course, has just ended, and what they are doing is interviewing quarterback Richard Todd out at Chase Stadium. And you know the story about Richard Todd. He took over after Matt Robinson jammed his thumb on a motel room door just about 48 hours prior to the season opener. They went with Robinson. He underthrew Wesley Walker a couple of times in key moments, and the Jets were beaten by Cleveland. Richard Todd now takes over, and what we're going to do is interrupt an interview with Kurt Gowdy and Richard Todd. We'll pick it up in progress. Let's go to Gowdy and Todd now.
To work this week. What was the attitude of the team? Were you really down?
We were really down the first part of the week, but we're a young team. We're going to make mistakes, but we're not as bad as we showed last week. We're a much better football team than that, and you know, we got a bunch of guys that are used to winning, and they know what it takes to win, and you know, we're going to get back on the right road now.
Now let's get your partner in there with you, Wesley Walker. Tell him that he had a fair day today. He only averaged 29 yards a catch.
There's some big scorch marks all over the field where he ran this afternoon.
Nice game, Wesley Walker. You came into this game way below your career average. You had averaged only 13 yards a catch. Today you averaged 29 yards a catch.
Oh, that's good to hear. I didn't know I did that well. Richard had a good day. I'm really happy for him because there's a lot of pressure been put on him to be thrown back in after the little adversities we've been through. But I'm glad to see him back on top and to give him some more confidence and myself also. But you can't just go by just the two games we played. It's still early in the season. I have a long ways to go and it's going to get tougher.
Wesley, I got the impression that you were drooling a little bit when you saw so much bump and run. Do you like to play against bump and run?
Oh, I love bump and run. Anytime you can get man to man, you know, somebody's going to get open. I think Derek was open on a couple of times, although I don't think he caught any passes. Our tight end got free, and it's just that we're on a hot streak, and I felt good, and Richard was looking for me.
And there they are, Brent, Todd Walker today, and they were hot, and they did it as the Jets won. And let's go now to Brent Musburger and NFL Today.
All right, Kurt and Hank Stram, thank you very much. Late word is just in. Atlanta has tied Denver at 17-all. Bartkowski to Wallace Francis. Now, those of you who have just joined us in New York and been with us in Los Angeles, let's show you some highlights from that Jet victory over the Detroit Lions. You know the story with the Lions. They are down to their third quarterback. Jeff Komlow has had to start because Gary Danielson has been lost, Joe Reed has been lost, and Komlow went to David Hill, the talented tight end. It was 7-0, Detroit over the Jets. Then back came the combination. You saw him interviewed. Wesley Walker splits the seams and gets down to the Detroit 15-yard line. And from there, it was Kevin Long behind the left side of Walt Michaels' offensive line, tied at 7. Todd once again. This time it will be Walker, the speedster from California working down the sideline. He'll get to the Lions' 7-yard line before he's pushed out of bounds. Once again, Kevin Long bounces across for the touchdown. 14-7, the Jets were up by a touchdown. Second half, here it is again. Richard Todd out of Alabama has now taken over the Jets again. Avoids the rush. Wants Walker 30 yards, and that sets up the next touchdown. This one scored by Scott Durkee, number 25, slams inside, and it was 24-10. Kevin Long, third touchdown. On the pitch from Todd, goes across for the score, and the Jets beat Detroit 31-10 is the final in Shea Stadium. And Irv, you've got highlights on the Saints-Eagles game.
That's right. That game's over right now, Britton. The Philadelphia Eagles defeated the New Orleans Saints by a score of 26-14, picking up their second win of the year. And the New Orleans Saints, with the most productive offense in football, have yet to win a game. Here's Ron Jaworski in the first half hitting Robert Montgomery on a touchdown strike, and Eagles took a 10-0 lead. Here's a play just before halftime. The Saints needed a desperation play, and Manning came up with it, hitting number 89, Wes Chandler. He goes 52 yards for a touchdown, and the score is 13-7 at halftime. But the Eagles came back late in the fourth quarter after controlling the ball game most of the second half. Going here to Billy Camfield, he scampers around right in, goes in, and the Eagles win it by a score of 26-14.
There's the final in that game, so two finals are in now, and we have another score on Tampa Bay. The amazing Buccaneers have scored again. They lead Green Bay. The score in that game is 14-3.
Very, very much, and we're here at Shea Stadium, where the Jets have just defeated the Lions 31-10. Kevin Long's down on the field. Kevin, for the second time in his Jet career, has scored three touchdowns in a game. He did it last year and again this year. That ties an all-time Jet record. Tell us about this week in practice, Kevin, as the week went along for you after your pasting last Sunday by the Patriots.
Well, we practiced a lot harder this week than we did in the past because we didn't feel like we was going practicing with that much intensity in practices the week before. So we really practiced hard this week in anticipation for a good game with Detroit this week.
Kevin, you know, the thing that impresses me about both you and Scott Durking is the fact not that you run so well, but in conjunction with that, you block for each other so well. Do you feel that's one of the strong features of your running attack?
I think it is. And, you know, that way they can't really key on me because if they key on me, then we'll run the halfback plays. And, you know, I just block for Scotty, and he usually get a good yardage from the halfback play. So, you know, it's kind of hard to key on one particular back.
Kevin, you fellas were running hard today. You were breaking tackles. When you were hit and slowed down, you fought for that extra yardage.
But this is something the running backs haven't been doing, you know, fighting for extra yardage. So, you know, now we're into the season, and we've gotten the kinks out of, you know, some of the bad things we was doing. And, you know, now we're ready to play football, and I hope we continue winning. We got 13 games left, so we're still in this thing.
You know, one of the other things that's very impressive is watching you two run. You run with your arms a lot, of course, naturally with your legs too, but you run a lot with your arms, but you're still able to maintain possession of the football, and you're not a fumbling team, which is very impressive.
Well, that comes from, you know, our coach, he sent us through a lot of drills where we line up and run through the line, and people try to pull the ball out of your arm, and we also work on the stiff arm technique, so I think we do that very well.
How much time do you spend during the course of the week on live pass protection, especially against the blitz?
Well, we spend, I say, about 50% of the practice, you know, blitz protection and, you know, things of that nature.
Kevin, Chris Ward has been taking some heat, called for holding in preseason. He's been concerned. Alzado went around him for three sacks. Baker got to the quarterback twice today. But I noticed a lot of your yardage was over the left side and running behind left tackle Chris Ward.
Yeah, Chris is definitely an excellent blocker. I think some of the press that he's had in the past couple of weeks has really had him off his game, so to speak. But today he showed that, you know, he's just going to put all that aside and play his game. And I think he did a really good job on Baker today.
Well, you have a great tackle on the left side, and you also have one on the right side who we think is one of the outstanding tackles in the National Football League, too. I'm sure you feel strongly about that also, don't you?
Yes, I think you're talking about Marvin Powell. I think he should make all pro this year. And, you know, you have Randy Rasmussen and Mickey Shule and Dan Alexander. Just everybody on the line does an excellent job. So, you know, I don't really want to stress one person because they all do a fine job. And without them, the running backs wouldn't be as successful as we are.
Hey, Kevin, when you were down there in the last minute and a half, first and goal to go, now, they all knew you had three touchdowns. Anybody say about getting a fourth one for you?
Well, I went back in for that purpose, but I have a sore ankle, and, you know, I really couldn't get to the outside. So we just said we'd wait till next time. We still got a couple more games to go, and I hope that I'll be at this point again where I could get the fourth touchdown.
All right, that's Kevin Long. He scored three touchdowns today. He was the leading ground gainer of the game. and he helped the Jets beat the Lions 31-10. Thank you, Kevin. We'll be back here in Shea Stadium with more right after this.
How long do you want your car to last?
Forever. It still pulls this trailer on our camping trips after more than 10 years.
Of course, the engine gets regular maintenance and Quaker State motor oil.
A lot of rough driving, too. Last year to Death Valley, and we're always to the Sierras backpacking.
Car's done over 100,000 miles, and it's still running fine.
Quaker State can't promise everyone that mileage, but Quaker State helps cars last.
I guess that's why it's the best-selling oil in America.
Those headlights coming towards you, believe it or not, can actually help save gas. As much as 0.2 mph. Developed by the Sylvania Lighting people, these special energy-saving halogen headlamps were put into practical use on one of the 79 model cars. And they're being used much more extensively on the 1980 automobiles.
G.
No, GTE.
All right, final, the Eagles 26, New Orleans 14. New Orleans now is winless. The Eagles are 2-1. Your old club, New Orleans, Hank.
Yeah, it's hard to understand that, really, because they're an excellent offensive team. They just haven't been able to stop anybody, and that's been their problem.
That's in the fourth period, Baltimore and Cleveland. Baltimore had a 10-0 lead. Brian Sipe got them back in there, and they're still going in Cleveland. The Browns won their first two games. Here's a tie, Denver and Atlanta in the fourth period. Denver had a 10-0 lead in that game, and Atlanta came back, and Bartoski just hit the pass to Francis, another heroic effort by Bartoski, it seems like, the last 2 years. New England had to scramble today to beat Cincinnati. They were rolled over by Buffalo, and New England's a peculiar club. Great talent. Week from week, sometimes they drop off a little and come back strong, but they win today, and they won two and lost one. Here's, Tampa Bay. Hank Stram has liked this club before the season opened, the regular season. He did their games in preseason. Tell us about Tampa Bay.
Well, Tampa's an excellent. Any time that you play as well as they do defensively, you have to respect their ability. They're terrifically outstanding on defense. They've got a good kicking game, and also they've improved dramatically offensively.
They'll be having Tampa Bay mania. They've got San Diego mania now. They had Bronco mania. It's all getting manias. 17-6. Houston over Kansas City, and a second-year quarterback, Nielsen, leading the Oilers today. The Vikings 12, Miami 7. Greasy injured his leg, had to be replaced by Strock in that game. And do we have any more coming up? That is it. All right. So let's stay tuned now. As next on CBS, we're going to have this word from your local station.
Television's most shining hour is back for another season with three brand new stories. Don't miss the premiere of the most celebrated broadcast of its kind in all television. 60 Minutes, tonight on CBS.